We don't need to hold on to things all the time. Sometimes we can just let things go and trust that there's a greater wisdom, that everything will fall into place nicely for us. My name is Angela. I am an IT professional. At the same time, I have a plethora of other interests. However, I find that one common thread of all my interests is that I really want to empower people. Because I feel empowered myself, I feel that I've gotten the know-how and the technique to how to empower myself, to live my life to the fullest. So now it's really about contributing to the rest, contributing to the world. I've been in this course for, I don't know, 2 more days, so actually 10 days. And I've actually, in a way, sifted it down to 3 major realizations. The first realization is that setting intention. Okay, so setting an intention daily, and it will sort of guide me throughout the day. My intention is to be well, because okay, now I'm down with a cold coming. So my intention is to be well and let my body heal itself. And in fact, the past few days, I set an intention to be grateful. Grateful for what I have and my life. And it really just opens up my world, because it's such a joy to be alive. And I smile at people, I smile at the bus driver, I smile at people in the MRT train. It's kind of like, wow. It's like, to me, it's like, hi, you know, you're alive. And to me, you know, setting intention is really important. And of course, we close it at the end of the day with acknowledgement. You know, we acknowledge ourselves and just the freedom to let things flow. A second one would be coaching. What is this about coaching? A coach asks questions. A coach does not tell. And we do it by pacing and leading. So you pace someone and finally you suggest, you lead them. You don't give a man a fish. You teach him how to fish. So that's exactly what the coach is doing. The coach is teaching you how to fish and pacing and leading you along the way. And there's so much here, you know, like building rapport, you know, matching and mirroring, body language. And to be a coach, I also know that I need to be fully present. I need to be there for that person. I cannot be a coach if I'm occupied with my own problems. And this is really something that I learned. You know, I have to be fully present. My intention is really to create a good session for the other guy. So that's the second realization. Then the third one is the mind and body is one. The mind affects the body, and so does the body affect the mind. So this is something I haven't really thought about, but you know, like Einstein said, imagination is the preview of life's coming attractions. So really, if you can see your mind's eye, you will adjust your body accordingly and things will start rolling. So really this emphasis against like what I learned, you know, I already live this oneness of mind and body, and I think through this course it has really deepened to another level. Yeah. So these are the 3 main things. So something that we are always very used to, I'm very used to, is, you know, tell someone to do something. Like I tell my sister, okay, please go and do that, please go and do that. And sometimes, you know, people are like that, humans are resistant. The more you tell them, the more they don't want to do it. So last night, you know, as I was about to tell my sister, okay, please go and do this thing, you know, I caught myself. I said, please go and then I thought, oh, the answer is in a question. So I paused, and then I think about how to phrase it in a question. And then I asked her, would it be possible that, you know, blah, blah, blah? Then she said, yes. Would it be possible that, blah, blah, blah? She said, yes. So therefore, would it be possible that by doing this, it will give you blah, blah, blah? And she said, yes. And then she went to do it. So to me, that was a revelation that really worked. So to be an effective communicator, or to just get your message across, right? Ask questions and let the person realize it for themselves. The metaphor that comes out very strongly for me is that, you know, I'm a painter. Okay, I have a brush and I have an empty canvas. What do I want to paint on this empty canvas? On one hand, I have references. Okay, I have references of beautiful paintings that were done by other people. And I know I have no painting skills. You know, I've not gone to a painting class. I do not know if I can paint. Should I follow what I see? Or should I follow my heart, you know, listen my heart? Really quieten down all the noise, because I think sometimes when we really quieten down all the noise that's happening around us and really just listen to what our heart has to say, you will intuitively know what picture you want to paint, right? So now the question is, once you know what picture you want to paint, sometimes fear comes up, right? We get gripped. Oh, what if the picture is not good? Or, you know, what if I'm not good? So then for me, it's really about what I learned in this class is there's no failure, only feedback. The key is to start taking action, and then from that action, see what happens. See what the universe responds to you, see what people around you respond to you, see how you grow in that process. Right, and then paint the masterpiece of your life.